exhibition? What is the kind of feedback you've seen? You know, what are the kind of exhibitors over here? And how is it going to help the surface and coatings industry?
I am the chairman of CII Corrosion Management Committee. The mandate is to see that corrosion is managed and mitigated. Our about 4% of GDP wealth is lost every year, which if you put together is 500,000 crores every year. Imagine this mind-boggling figure. And you please blow this back to education, healthcare, taking care for poverty alleviation. What does it mean to the country every year? So we have been working for about 10 years to see that how it can be reduced. Throughout the world, different countries have tried to manage this corrosion, and Japan is the best example, which have brought this loss to 1% of GDP. Can we bring from 4% to 2%, and after 10 years, 1%? So this is the committee which I am heading. So I came here to give a keynote talk to tell what my experience has been there for more than 45 years now in managing corrosion. Nuclear industry, defense, space, small industries, medium industries, and how we can take the best practices, how we can create new science, how we can bring the most gifted young people into this stream, who can manage or do research, who can teach, who can create certified people who actually manage the corrosion in the industry. So that was my purpose. Exhibition has been phenomenal. If you go around the conference, exhibition, I have spent 45 years. I have seen some products which are extremely good with respect to managed corrosion. I'd give you an example. That very simple gun with which you spray the corrosion painting. The kind of sophistication which has come into it prevents the health hazard to the person who is making a coating. It doesn't release much paint material which is organic, environmentally not good to the environment, makes a uniform coating. So one awareness that every painter in the country, you must have seen hundreds of painters. How many of them you have seen with the proper application of a gun? Suppose that change is made, one simple change, how much difference would it make to the country? Then you have very sophisticated devices like robots, you have the measurements as to how the coatings and paints are there and not. So I think even for a person who has been all along their life, there is a solution. And those who are new, who are searching for the solution, they definitely find how the new products are there and all that. Only we are discussing this morning that can we bring the small and micro industries who would benefit a lot, but they don't survive. If they don't adopt the new technology, they don't survive. How do we bring them to give that experience? They feel we are a light group and big industries and all scholars, professors, but ultimately it has to go to small and micro industry. So this is something which we'd like to do next time. And we have started thinking as a CMC, as a CII, Avanta Center, how do we do it? Yeah.
So what are some of the challenges that the surface and coating industry faces, in especially in India, you know, where there are so many issues that we tackle day-to-day workings? So what do you think are the challenges, sir?
You see, we have all the technologies. The industry has to become aware that the money spent on the corrosion protection would give you back 3 or 4 times more. It would also make the machinery run for a longer period without maintenance. I believe the biggest challenge today is awareness. They feel it is expenditure. They don't feel it as a return on investment. And sometimes we feel that the industry feels that this is a problem I have to live. Corrosion is a problem I have to live with. Like somebody says aging is a problem you have to live with. But another fellow says, no, through meditation, through exercise, through proper food, you can live for 100 years. So I'm not living with the problem of aging. There's another guy of 40 years old, he says aging is a problem, no, I've become 50 now. Corrosion is something like that. They don't recognize that there are solutions to everything which they are doing. How to do it? For big industries, I can do it. How to take it to every citizen? How I take it to the person who is laying a sewage line and saying that it will start leaking and cause a lot of problem, but you can take care of it by proper choice of material, by proper coating, by proper painting and all that. Awareness is itself not there. CT corporations, I don't think in their whole deliberation even one time say that corrosion prevention they have to do. They are busy with all kind of problem, but corrosion prevention is not on them. So how to take it to all these people? That's a challenge. Otherwise, we run nuclear energy program, space program. We don't have corrosion. We know how to manage corrosion and do it. Mm-hmm. There are petrochemical industries which run at 120%, whether it is ONGC or IOL or Reliance. They run at very high capacities and as good as anywhere else in the world. So at one hand, we have the pockets of excellence. On the other hand, we have issues that it doesn't go to the place where a lot of GDP is getting lost. GDP is not being lost in the sophisticated industry. GDP is being lost in consumer products, in small industries, medium industries, who don't recognize the value of this.
It was great speaking to you and